Hi guys, today a review of the Maple Trolley Bag for ice skating and inline skating. As you can see, it's a very large bag. It has lots of room. Let me show you. Front compartment. You can put your inline or ice skates on the outside of the bag and also on the inside. You can lock it with a little key, with a little lock. It has quite a large inside. You can also lock your skates in place with those straps. A little bit fiddly, but they are okay. Here is some room for your laptop if you need that. You can also strap that with a little Velcro strap. So a very large compartment. You can put all your skating gear in that. You can also take it on a holiday. I did take it on a holiday and I used it in the ice skate ring of Heerenveen. Tialf ice skate ring. But I don't skate there anymore, so I don't use my car that often. This big bag is too big to take it on your bicycle. It's too heavy, too big. So I don't use it anymore, or not much anymore. I have used it in the past, but nowadays I don't really use it because I use a backpack for that. There is also a handle in it. I show you. So you can roll it around like so, and there comes the difficulty. I find it a downfall because it has rolling wheels, and in the past there was rubber on that, but I got a stone stuck in one of the wheels, and one of the wheels totally flattened out, so it bounced about. And that wasn't nice, so I got rid of all the rubber, so the wheels are a bit smaller. But the problem with that is you can't take the wheels out, so that's a bit of a downfall. It rolls nice now, and this one also, but you rather have rubber on it because it's a little bit bouncy when you have it like plastic, and when this grinds down, yeah, the wheels are gone. So that's not really nice, but okay, it's not else than that. Then there is a little compartment in the back for maybe your keys or your money, I don't know. And here is also a little not even a little compartment, but a big compartment. And that's the second downfall. There are straps on it to take it on your back, but it's very large on your back, and when you got all your gear in it, it's way too heavy. It might weigh what I was used to as a marine, about 30-40 kilograms, and that's way too much to carry around on your back. The straps aren't that padded, so they can grind in your shoulders. Not that nice, maybe a little bit hurting. I did never use that. Not that great of a deal with the straps. If you have maybe almost no gear in it, I would take a smaller bag. But if you have almost no gear in, maybe you can. But not really, I think. You have to use it like this. You put this part up, like so. And then you do them on these parts, like so. I hope you can see it, like so, and like this one also, like so. But you can see it's not that great, and I have tried it, that those plastic parts are in the lower side of your back, and they can hurt. Not really a deal. It's not that padded on this side when you put this one in. Well, it's a bit hard. Not really a backpack. But overall, a very large bag for skating, inline skating, and maybe your holidays. So if you want a one and all bag, maybe this is the one for you. It isn't sold much anymore. You can still buy them, They aren't that expensive anymore. I think about 70 euros. In the past they were about 125 until 150 euros, 150 euros. And that was quite a lot. I bought this one cheaper when Maple stopped producing products. So it got out of business. But it's a great bag, but not a backpack. So here is my review. I hope you liked it. If you liked it, give it a thumbs up. And if you didn't like it, don't subscribe. But otherwise, subscribe please. Thanks for watching. Until the next time. Bye bye.